Today we will talk in detail about the first step, that is complaints. Complaints has been dealt in detail in the Central Vigilance Commission's manual 2017 edition. So always keep that with you, and also the various instructions issued by the Department of Personnel Training, which are available on their website, and we will go through them. I have dealt with the complaint in two parts. The today's video I will talk about the general instructions issued on complaint, and more particularly the how to deal with anonymous pseudonymous complaints. Today's video will confine ourselves to discussion on the sources of the complaint, how anonymous and pseudonymous complaints are dealt with, particularly because this causes a lot of confusion I have seen in the various departments. Despite very clear instructions, people still ask, and rightly so, that whether anonymous complaints, if they have a verifiable facts in that anonymous complaint, should we act on it? The answer is no, we should not, even if there are verifiable facts in the anonymous complaint. So we'll see why this confusion still continues to persist. Then we will talk about the complaint handling policy of the commission. What are the cases they send for investigation and report? What are the cases they send for necessary action? And what is to be done by the department when such directions are received from the Central Vigilance Commission? We will also talk in complaints that what specific action has to be taken when the complaints is received in the department, in the ministry, not through Central Vigilance Commission. And also action on complaints received by the central public sector enterprises, public sector banks, public sector insurance companies. For the sake of breaking the videos into digestible chunks, I will talk about only this portion, sources of complaint, anonymous and pseudonymous complaints, and rest of the three we will talk in the next video. The Central Vigilance Commission Manual 2017 Chapter 3 provides detailed guidelines on complaints. Now, information about corruption, malpractices or misconduct on the part of the public servant may flow to the administrative authority, to the Central Vigilance Commission, to the CBI or the police authorities from any of the following sources. Now, it could be from the employees or from the public. It could be from departmental inspection reports, which are very valuable sources of detection of occasions of misconduct, corruption, stock verification surveys, even newspapers, internal whistleblowers, CAG reports, audit reports, scrutiny of annual property statements filed under conduct rule and other statements filed under the conduct rules, a report of parliamentary committees, etc. Now, if received verbally in the department by the CVO or from the source information, it is necessary to reduce that into writing if it is from an identifiable source. The complaints could be anonymous, pseudonymous. This is very, very common question which arises in how to deal with anonymous, pseudonymous complaints. Anonymous complaints are those complaints which do not have both name and address. Both name and address. Pseudonymous could be a false name, could be there. It could be signed also. Other than anonymous complaints that we receive, we have to check whether there are verifiable facts or non-verifiable facts in it. It is vague or not. So anonymous complaints we will simply file. We will talk about it a little while later in detail. But so far as other than anonymous complaints are concerned, we will see whether there are verifiable facts or not. If it is vague, no non-verifiable facts are there, we will simply file it. Now, we will also have to check the chief vigilance officer's, one of the most important duties, to check whether the nature of complaints is vigilance in nature, corruption matters are involved, or it is purely administrative. In the last video, you have seen that we have talked about what is a vigilance angle and what is not. So if it is not a vigilance angle, it is purely administrative and has to be dealt by the department. Now, if it is pseudonymous complaints, or a sender has given his name, it is identifiable, name, address, identifiable, then we will, even then we will send it for verification. We'll confirm from the sender whether he owns or disowns the complaint made. So it is very clearly mentioned that we will have to send it to him, wait for 15 days, and then decide. If no reply comes, we'll file it. If reply comes, then we will decide what further action to be taken. If no reply is received from the sender, even in case of pseudonymous or signed complaint, it to be filed. Now, DOPT has very clearly talked about this in their office memorandum dated 18-10-2013, and also CVC wide their circular dated 25th November 2014. We'll talk about it very much in detail today. Now, we have talked about complaint, the sources of it, but what if the complaint is false and malicious? Now, kindly note that the CVC manual chapter 3 also talks about that a genuine complainant should be afforded protection against harassment or victimization. It is true. If he is harassed and victimized, it is the duty of the CVO to see that it is not done and necessary action is taken. However, this is important. However, serious notice should be taken if a complaint is after verification found to be false and malicious. If it has been done with the ulterior motive of maligning somebody. Now, there should be no hesitation in taking severe departmental action or launching even criminal prosecution against such complainants. Now, this has been done because it is often seen that people in the garb of complaining would try to malign the person without any basis, without any evidence. Complaints would be made and then the inquiry would start and the government servant who may otherwise be innocent suffers severe damage in terms of reputation. Now, action taken on complaints received in the CVC and the action taken in the department, this I will talk about in the next video. In today's video, now let us immediately go and try to understand what has been the instructions so far on dealing with anonymous and pseudonymous complaints. Now, it is interesting, very interesting to see the history of the instructions issued on anonymous and pseudonymous complaint to appreciate that why even now there is this question often asked that if there are some verifiable facts in the anonymous complaint, should we act on it or should we file it? As I told you, the answer is even if there are verifiable facts in an anonymous complaint, it should be filed. But why this question persists is because in 1992, the Department of Personnel and Training issued an office memorandum on 29th September in which it was stated that no action should be taken on anonymous pseudonymous complaint. So I have written it A by P to just to shorten the space. So anonymous and pseudonymous complaint, no action to be taken. But a small window was left open. This office memorandum enabled the authorities the option to inquire if there were some verifiable details in that anonymous complaint. So, you know, this confusion and this obvious question is that if there is an anonymous complaint, but there is some verifiable facts he has given, then ministries would not be able to, you know, very clearly decide what to do on whether they should investigate or should not investigate, should file it or not file it. So this continued. In 1999, the Central Vigilance Commission also issued a circular prescribing that no action on anonymous pseudonymous complaints should be taken. Now you can see in 90, Government of India DOPT issued that if there are verifiable facts, you may investigate, whereas CVC made it very clear that no action to be taken on anonymous on pseudonymous complaint. And in this CVC circular, There was not this option available of verifiable details or not. Now in 2002, CVC reiterated their earlier instructions that, and now they've made it very clear that under no circumstances any investigation be commenced on anonymous pseudonymous complaints. So CVC was very clearly issuing instructions that on anonymous and pseudonymous complaints, no investigation should be carried out. On the other hand, the DOPT instructions of 1992, which were still in place, it provided that in case there are verifiable details. So this obviously caused little bit of confusion in amongst those who were handling vigilance matters and discipline matters. Now in 2002, CVC made a small U-turn. Means CVC now issued an instructions on 11th October 2002 that and reconsidered its earlier decision and held that in case of verifiable facts, the CVO may refer to the CVC whether investigation is necessary or not. So now the CVC circular dated 2002 was by and large in line with the Government of India DOPT instructions that in case of verifiable details, investigation may take place. So that small window was left open. In 2013, DOPT issued instructions on 18th October 2013, which provided that no action on anonymous complaints, irrespective of the nature of the allegation and complaints, and it should be filed. So, irrespective of the nature of the allegation, in other words, now DOPT's 2013 instructions were a modification of their earlier view that in case of verifiable facts, this action investigation may take place. But now they said even if there are verifiable facts, it is to be filed. Thereafter, in 2014, CVC withdrew its circular dated 11-10-2000. In which earlier the CVC had held that in case of verifiable facts, the chief vigilance officer may refer it to the Central Vigilance Commission. So as the thing stands today, as the position stands today, these are the two OMs which are applicable, 2013 and 2014. And both these instructions very clearly lay down that even if there are verifiable facts, the anonymous complaint should be filed. What is anonymous complaint? In which both name and address are not there. So now let us very quickly recapitulate again through a flowchart as to what action is to be taken when you receive any kind of a complaint. Now sources of complaint, as you remember, are inspection report, press report, audit report, complaint by a whistleblower or a public or a person from within the organization. Now when we receive a complaint, basically, as we said, there are two possibilities. It could be anonymous, it may not be anonymous. Now, in case if it is anonymous, that is both name and address are not there, we have to ignore that complaint, we have to file it. No action is required to be taken. So, let us be very clear, in case of anonymous complaint, even if there are verifiable facts, it has to be filed. On the other hand, if it is not an anonymous complaint, a person has signed it, but the complaint is vague. If it is vague, even then the instructions of the 2013 provides that it has to be ignored and filed. Suppose it is not vague, there are details available which are verifiable. In that case, the instructions provide, and this is important, the instructions provide that we will seek confirmation from the complainant, and after sending the confirmation, we'll wait for 15 days. If no reply is received, we will again send a reminder to the person concerned, wait for 15 days. Even after the 15 days, no reply is received, again we will file it. In case we receive a reply and the complainant owns the complaint made by him, and in that case, only the CVO will now take a call as to what further action should be taken, whether investigation is necessary or not. So further action will be taken only if he confirms. So what is the DOPT instructions issued? As I said, please remember, this is the DOPT instructions which has been issued, dated 18th October 2013. It is available on the website and we will take you to the website and discuss. Whenever you want to see any instructions, the DOPT website is a wonderful site, very well organized, and come to dopt.gov.in, dopt.gov.in, and then to the notifications. From there, go to the OMs and orders, and you will find all the orders given in this site subject wise. So you will find administrative tribunals, administrative, RRNDC, RTI, on other topics like canteen, welfare, sports, reservation for scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, then court cases like this. Now in this, if you go to vigilance and come to vigilance, and it is such a beautiful way of searching. The DOPT website is excellent in easy, quick retrieval of instructions, that if you type complaint, you will get highlighted all the DOPT instructions on complaint. Now, if we go to the next one, it is 8-10-2018, guidelines regarding handling of complaints. Now, on this OM, I am showing you this because this was a OM not laying down any new instructions. Basically, it wanted to compile all the instructions together, and this was the office memorandum issued on 8th October 2018. Now you can see it says the undersigned is directed to say that the instructions regarding dealing with anonymous pseudonymous complaints were issued on 18-10-2013. Now this is a very important instruction that we will try to see, and that no action is required to be taken on anonymous complaints irrespective of the nature of the allegations, and that such complaints need to be simply filed. So I repeat the word, irrespective of the nature of the allegations, irrespective of the nature of the allegation, and that such complaints need to be simply filed. So 2013 OM very clearly laid down that no action is to be taken on anonymous complaint irrespective of the nature. However, a clarification was again issued on 18-6-2014. Why, I will show you, I will tell you. But before that, we will have to first read the 18-10-2013. Now, let us go to 18-10-2013 OM. Now, this is the office memorandum for 18-10-2013 is the office memorandum issued, which is comprehensively dealing with the complaints, anonymous complaints. Now you can see it starts with that the undersigned is directed to say that the instructions regarding dealing with anonymous pseudonymous complaint as contained in this department's OM dated 1992, when the OM was issued, it provided that no action to be taken. However, in case of verifiable facts, action can be initiated. In para 2, it says the matter was examined afresh in the consultation with the Central Vigilance Commission. Subsequent to the public interest disclosure and in protection of information resolutions, PIDB, which is called PIDB, the commission has created a mechanism for handling complaints where identity of the complainant is kept secret, and therefore the complainant is provided protection. In view of the PIDB mechanism which was started, in para 3, the government says, in view of the fact that the complainants who desire to protect their identity now have the protection of PIDB, a new procedure has been laid down. Laid down on what day? On October 2013. And let us see what that procedure is. Now, it is important to read the English. Now, therefore, it is saying, the following procedure is laid down for handling anonymous pseudonymous complaints in supersession of instructions contained in DOPT's OM number 321/491, 29 September 1992. So 92 OM is being superseded, and now it is saying, first line, no action is required to be taken on anonymous complaints irrespective of the nature of the allegation, and such complaints need to be simply filed. So, in case now in your department you are getting any anonymous complaint, just simply file it. No application of mind. You have to do nothing. Now, second, para 3.2i says, complaints containing vague allegations could also be filed without verification of identity of the complainant. So, in case of a vague allegation, could also be filed without verification of identity of the complainant. And now, therefore, again, a small confusion has arisen. That means if it is not a vague allegation, it cannot be filed. So if there is a vague allegation, it could be filed. And if the allegation is not vague, then it cannot be filed. So everybody started thinking that even in anonymous complaints, if the allegation is not vague, that means there are verifiable facts, then can we file it? Please see that anonymous complaints has been dealt within 3.1i. Now this 3.2i is talking of complaints which are not anonymous. That means if it is not an anonymous complaint, then even then it can be filed if it is vague. And finally, in para 3i, 3.3i, this is the para 3.3i, finally the DOPT is saying, if a complaint contains verifiable allegation. Now this is all referring, please see, this is referring to a complaint which is not anonymous. So if somebody has given you his name and address, then now if you see the para 3.3i, it says if a complaint contains verifiable allegations. Which complaint? Obviously a complaint which is not anonymous. Anonymous complaint has been already dealt in the said same office memorandum in para 1. So no action is required to be taken on anonymous complaint. So all other instructions are pertaining to those complaints which are not anonymous. So if a complaint contains verifiable allegations, which is not anonymous, you can read that. The administrative ministry may take cognizance of such complaint with the approval of the competent authority to be designated by the ministry as per their distribution of work. In such cases, the complaint will be first sent to the complainant for owning / disowning as the case may be. If no response is received from the complainant within 15 days of sending the complaint, a reminder will be sent. After waiting for 15 days, after sending the reminder, if still nothing is heard, the said complaint may be filed as pseudonymous by the ministry department. So if a complainant does not own or confirm that he has made the complaint, then you will file it as pseudonymous complaint. So you must see this instruction dated 18th October 2013 in case of a doubt. Still a doubt remains that what to be done in case of an anonymous complaint having a verifiable fact. So if an anonymous complaint have a verifiable fact, it has to be simply filed. In 2014, the DOPT clarified that anonymous complaints are those complaints which does not have both name and address. So both name and address is not there in a complaint, it is an anonymous complaint. And it clarified that complaints other than anonymous complaints which contain vague allegations, as I was telling you, the para 3.2i was causing confusion as to whether it is applicable for anonymous complaints or not. So they clarified this is applicable to complaints other than anonymous complaints. If it is vague allegations, it need to be dealt in terms of para 3.2i, which says file it if it is vague. And complaint which contain verifiable allegations are to be done as per para 3.3i. That is, you have to send it to the complainant for owning or disowning. If he confirms, then the competent authority may take an action for the decision to investigate further. In case of anonymous complaint, it is simply to be filed, para 3.1i. So anonymous complaints are to be filed. Other than anonymous complaints, if it is vague, it is to be filed. If it is not vague, if it contains verifiable facts, then it has to be first sent to the complainant for owning, disowning. If no reply sends is received by the ministry department, then only it has to be filed as a pseudonymous complaint. So let us come back to the history as we were seeing. So 1992, DOPT issued an OM. Nothing to be done in case of anonymous complaint. However, left a window open by saying that you enabled an option to inquire on verifiable facts, which continued But in 1999, contrary to what DOPT had said, CVC issued a circular that no action is to be taken on anonymous pseudonymous complaint. In 2002, CVC reiterated on January 2002 that under no circumstances any investigation be commenced on anonymous pseudonymous complaints. However, the same year in October, they now clarified if the complaint, that is anonymous complaints, has a verifiable facts, the CVO may refer the matter to CVC in case they want to investigate further. However, in 2013, now DOPT again clarified that irrespective of the nature of anonymous complaint, no action is required to be taken and the allegations and the complaint is to be filed. This one we have seen in detail. Following the order from DOPT, Central Vigilance Commission also withdraws its circular dated 2002, where it said that if there are verifiable facts, investigation is possible. So now, as concluding, I repeat again that in case of an anonymous complaint, it is to be filed. Even if the complainant has provided you very clear, verifiable. So thank you very much. We will be next time very soon with the new video on how to deal with complaints in the ministries, how to deal with complaints received in the public sector banks, and how to deal with complaints received in the central public sector enterprises, which will be numbered as 4A. Bye-bye. Thank you.